That was Vincent by Don McLean. And that ties into our next section actually really well. We're doing an embrace debate where we're going to be talking about the recent vandalization of the sunflower painting by Van Gogh by climate activists. So for this segment, we're going to be kind of just trying to take both sides and just talking it through in a respectful and peaceful way to try and promote a healthy discourse.
Yeah. Well, you guys know more about this than me, so maybe you just go into like the why this was a move against oil corporation.
Do you want to give the background?
So, yeah, I'll give the background. Okay. Essentially, a group called Just Stop Oil, which is made up of mainly young people, went into the, I think it was the National Gallery, and poured tomato soup over the one of the only six surviving images of the sunflowers by Van Gogh, which he painted in 1888 and 1889. And their kind of motive was to bring light to the topic and I guess say that we need to spend more time trying to protect people than just art was essentially their message.
Yeah. And it says here too that they'd been in they'd been in London for a while. Like they'd been protesting for a few weeks before they did this. So I guess just different actions, and then this was kind of the culmination of their protest against.
Right.
And wasn't there like a recent like event for like the UK where they were like purchasing oil or something that made them particularly lash out?
It was something like that. It was a recent purchase, or they want the UK to like stop all their oil purchasing. And they like poured it over the painting. The painting was not damaged, I'd like to point out. It has glass over it.
Glass cover.
And it's completely fine. It's back on display now. And then they glued themselves to the wall. But
which they did. They've done that before. They did it at Da Vinci's The Last Supper too.
This is and it's a common thing for it's like handcuffing yourself to something except for
And that was also done I think that was a different organization, but during the French Open tennis tournament people that was a problem where people would like go run onto the court and handcuff themselves
I've seen videos of that and it also, just to provide some more background, it was because the UK were giving out new licensees to companies that were doing like underwater fossil fuel extraction.
Okay.
So that's kind of like, cause obviously all countries are like using fossil fuels.
Right.
So, but this new licensing program kind of gave way to even more and an even greater, amount of it.
Right. I'd say. Okay. So, who wants to
embrace debate?
Start with their point that they'd like to
argue. I mean, obviously, like fossil fuels right now, we need it for the foreseeable future until like renewable energy sources and like nuclear energy are more sustainable and like adapted into our infrastructure, because there's not that many like nuclear power plants around. Like some countries do a better job. The U.S., not as much nuclear energy. Illinois, actually, number one state for nuclear energy. All right. So there's another fun fact about
Illinois.
But yeah, so I'd just say that like I can see why the UK would do something like this.
Right.
I do think they might want to like put more energy into... Mm-hmm.
That's what I think, yeah. They're kind of arguing that they're not trying hard enough.
Yeah, which is fair. Like I feel like this time... Like we all kind of are starting to understand how serious this fight is, but I don't know. I guess we'll get into this later, but there's just definitely better ways to go about doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what I'd like to talk about is like how it was kind of like, I absolutely agree with the message. And I think that there's like, the whole thing is like, why did you have to like go after this painting? And even when the painting isn't really involved, like Van Gogh loved nature and all this stuff. But the reason why is like you said, they had been protesting in London for weeks and no one had heard of it. And like now the whole world knows. And like, I agree that it's not like, these are beautiful pieces of art that shouldn't be destroyed. And I don't know if they knew it was, I'm sure that they probably knew that it was had glass, or maybe they didn't and they actually just wanted to destroy it. But giving them the best case, they just wanted to get publicity on it.
Yeah, that was like their number one reason. It's right. What I've read, that's what it said.
Mm-hmm. It's not about actually that they hate art. And it kind of doesn't make sense because like art isn't, I mean, sure, art does produce some like fossil fuels, but it's not anywhere near the main like contributor in
not,
any way.
It's no, not, like, it's not. I also was wondering like why there was a specific like attack on this particular piece. I think it's just because it's a popular piece.
Yeah, yeah, I think that that's, I don't think it has any...
$80.9 million.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.
Yeah, and also, I think it is kind of a weird thing because a lot of Van Gogh's like post-impressionist paintings are of natural beauty. So, but I guess that's kind of showing also, that they're destroying the natural beauty of the art. So mm-hmm. it's kind of showing how adding the new licensing program could destroy the like natural ecosystems underwater around the UK.
Yeah, which is interesting to me that they chose, like, I understand what they were saying, like, get to save, like, human lives before you, like, save art. But I feel like if you're climate activists, you'd be, like, more towards, like, you have to save, like, the planet or, like, the environment.
It does say they were also protesting the cost of living crisis.
Yeah, that's what they were talking about, almost more about people than the environment.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I found that to be interesting. I mean, my thoughts just kind of summed up was like, first of all, they accomplished their goal, like kind of whether you like it or not, because we're talking about it right now.
Right, right.
And I think that's like a good thing to do to get, especially young people talking about this issue is really important. But I disagree with the medium by which they decided to go about this. And like the more I've learned about it, the less kind of like against this event I've become, but I still like kind of just disagree with the whole idea of trying to like vandalize a really famous work of art that someone, if you like listen to the lyrics of the song, made like over 100 years ago and was like a like tortured soul and all that kind of stuff. So I don't know. I stand against that particular part, but I think there is a certain point where people have to start taking this problem seriously.
Right. And I think that's kind of what they're saying is like, you know, this is an extreme thing to do for sure. But that's kind of what we need a little bit is like, we need they're kind of showing that people are tired of it. And I agree that maybe it's not the best way of doing it, but they're at least showing the world that, you know, we're tired of us just like yelling out and no government's hearing. Like there's just not much action being done. And so they're kind of upping the ante to try and get, you know, to try and get movement going. And I absolutely agree with that. But I just think, again, maybe a different
medium. Yeah, I think to get back to Cal's point, it's like, why bring Van Gogh into this? Like he already had enough like life challenges. And I know his art now, like the contemporary view of his art is much kind of removed from his personal like character, and it's like art is obviously different than the artist, but still it's like, why not a different painting, you know?
Right.
There's just I guess the value of it is so great that kind of is a good target for someone, but
okay
I've got a quote from the Washington Post. I just want to talk about it briefly. All this is misdirected and counterproductive. It makes the urgency of the crisis seem ridiculous to people who are already disinclined to give credence to the science of global warming. And they create a false moral choice for those who love both art and the environment.
I completely agree.
Yeah.
A lot of big words in that statement, but I liked what it said.
I think that once again, Cal brought up yesterday when we were talking about it, is that like this gives something for the people who either don't believe in climate change or don't want to do anything about climate change to point at and be like, those people are crazy.
Exactly.
Yeah. Like they're doing all this stuff. It doesn't really make any sense.
It can literally victimize the governments that are creating these licenses.
Which I think is something programs. That definitely needs to be talked about. But I do still think that
they're literally villainizing themselves, which is when you're trying to create global awareness.
Right.
That's,
I think really that that's kind of, I don't know. It's somehow a cost that they seem like they want to do. It's like they, I don't know, they just feel like,
I guess
it's it's worth the villainization for the press. Right. It is like urgent. Mm-hmm. That's their gambit.
It's an urgent issue, and they want to make all the headlines. Because like Washington mm-hmm. Post, I see a CNBC article.
Yeah, everywhere.
It's everywhere, yeah.
So.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, well, cool. That was our Embrace Debate segment. Next up, after a short break, is Us and Them by Pink Floyd.
That was Here Comes the Sun by The Beatles. For our second segment, we're going to do our third Mount Rushmore of the year.
Yeah.
I was lucky enough to win last week when we did Mount Rushmore of breakfast foods.
It was a close one. There were many judges.
We did a lot of votes last time. Time before, we just had one judge, but this time we had five or six?
Judges as it took for a count to be
won. Okay. So, let me just get out ahead of this. We did... three people, and after the first three votes, Kyle had two, Hayes had one, I had none, and then two more people were approached. They both voted for me. We had never discussed how many people we were going to have vote. So in my defense, that's why.
Two more people were asked. And then we asked one. We asked the final person. Jack Kovac, my roommate. And he decided that. Cal won.
Okay, so here we are. So I choose.
And I'm not mad about it, by the way. Okay.
Only winless one here. Anyway, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So I'm going to go with the same order. So me first, followed by Hayes, and then Kyle, and we'll wrap back around. It's going to be Mount Rushmore of potatoes.
Yeah, different preparations of potatoes. Yeah. Anything you want.
This is exciting. I'm really excited for this.
Really, potatoes just have such a wide variety. They're beautiful perfect. Food.
They're starchy.
Up there for most versatile.
Honestly, they're up
Ireland.
There.
And they don't carry a lot of that on their shoulder. You know, they're kind of just like potato. They're not
workhorse.
Flashy.
Yeah, they're not flashy at all.
I'd say they're a superfood. Okay.
I don't know.
They're literally a superfood. No. I don't know if like
they're
not nutritionally.
I don't think nutritionally they're like pretty much nutritionally devoid of.
They're like the most basic food of all time.
It's just carbs.
Well, okay. Let's get on with it then.
Yeah.
First pick for me.
This is a big
I'm not going to overthink it. It's mashed potatoes.
Okay. I was hoping you wouldn't pick that.
Because it's just, I don't really need to explain it. It's one of those things. Everyone loves it at Thanksgiving. You can have it anytime. Mm-hmm. They're just so good.
Do you have it a lot at home? Like,
I don't have it that much because we're a pasta family.
Of course, tortellini.
Exactly. So we have pasta a lot, but when we have mashed potatoes, it's amazing. Mm-hmm. Mashed potatoes, first pick.
Okay. Good pick. That's honestly probably my favorite way to eat potatoes. Just mashed potatoes and like a steak. Oh, so good. Mm. So good. All right. Well, I'm up now. I'm going to go with hash browns, okay?
Whoa.
I know.
High pick.
It might come to bite me, but I just love hash browns.
Good pick.
I think like, and I'm not talking about home fries. I'm talking about hash browns. Talking about like shredded kind of potatoes. Okay. So good.
Not McDonald's.
Well, which one do you prefer?
No.
You get the whole thing. You get the whole
count,
thing.
I would say as well.
But which do you prefer?
Yeah. I'd say I prefer this like shredded like Waffle House style.
Yeah, Waffle House makes it.
Waffle House keeps coming out. I've still never been there.
Diner hash browns like that. Like, I mean, it's pretty similar to Waffle House, but it's just such a like thing that almost every diner has, and it's just so good every time. So good to complement eggs or a waffle. It's just such a good like.
Yeah. Actually, I have to support that because when I had the Waffle House challenge and I was literally dying in a Waffle House.
What is the Waffle House challenge, Cal? Do you want
to? You have to spend 24 hours in a Waffle House. Every waffle you eat is minus an hour. Punishment for losing my fantasy football league.
Mm-hmm.
Me and my friend Mac got locked in Waffle House. And anyway, we got so tired of eating waffles, we just ordered hash browns at one point just to like cut through everything. And it changed the game.
Yeah. They're so good. They're just a good like complimentary part. I mine scattered, smothered, covered. That's with a cheese on top, onions in there.
Oh my gosh.
So good.
Wow.
So good.
That's incredible. Okay. All right. I feel like you guys left out two of the big names in the potato family.
Okay, mister, I've never won.
Okay. And I'm going to go with potato chips and French fries.
Oh, I was hoping.
L pick.
I was hoping I was going to get one of the three that you guys picked on the way back, but no chance.
No, guys.
I thought that was a bad pick, honestly. I'm not into French fries. I'm not a French fry guy.
Okay, well, you're not the general population. Okay.
All right.
I my picks, as with last time with the breakfast foods, I chose very basic, popular, can't go wrong
but
breakfast
you lost.
Foods. But I was winning. So I had done something right. So I think potato chips, obviously, there's so many. You can't say potato chips are a bad pick. You like mm-hmm. even if you don't like potato chips,
yeah, it's
you're going to eat potato chips because it's everywhere. Yeah. It's everywhere.
Good with the
Lay's,
sandwich.
Barbecue potato Utz, chips.
Shout out Baltimore.
Sour onion. Cream cheese.
Yeah.
Just so much variety.
Wait. Cream cheese?
Okay. No, it's a flavor of Lay's. Okay. I was mixing them up.
Ew.
No.
That sounds gross.
No. It's sour cream and onion. That's what I was thinking of.
And you said cream
cheese.
That's
different from cream cheese.
Okay.
By a lot.
Well, guys, I tried. Okay. Okay? And then the other one, French fries. You can't.
Self-explanatory.
I mean, French fries. I
thought that would have gone second, honestly.
I don't love French fries, honestly.
Well, I don't think it matters if you love or hate it. You have to pick French fries in a potato draft high. I thought you would have totally taken that.
Especially as a third.
I think that might come to bite me because I just don't like love them, but I think a lot of people do. So yeah. I think
talk more about your opinion on French fries, Hayes. How do you feel about them?
I mean, I like them, but I just think that there's like in the world of potatoes, there's like a lot of
okay, so when you go to like a really nice, when the Wilkie Meyer family goes out to a really nice French restaurant and you order frites, you just eat the steak.
No, I eat the frites, but I order. Well, then, I normally will order onion
cap.
Rings, actually.
Well, that's cap.
Instead. Because I prefer onion rings.
Okay.
Oh
okay.
This what? Guy. All right. Yeah, fine. Wow. Do your second pick, Hayes.
All right. My second pick. This is going to be an explosive pick.
Don't do the pick.
It's Noki.
Oh.
No.
No.
That was my sleeper.
That was my
next
pick.
Such a good
pick. Noki. And people don't really think about how it's potato, but it is so good.
Oh my gosh. I thought you guys were going to completely forget about that.
Noki's so good.
Dang it.
Oh, it's just, I can't even start talking about how good Noki is.
You already did.
Whoa.
So anyway,
gnocchi,
gnocchi.
It's pronounced gnocchi.
Yeah, gnocchi.
But okay. I always get clowned in my family for calling it gnocchi. But
yeah,
it's
gnocchi.
It's spelled with a G.
Yeah, G-N-O-C-C-H-I.
But the
G
is kind of silent.
Kind of.
Okay, that's a good. If you maybe could have waited on that for coming back, I don't think I was gonna pick it because I thought you guys
were. I was worried
were
you were.
I was gonna pick
that weren't
I was
gonna pick
it.
Well, yeah, but I could have picked it next.
Yeah, you could have.
Okay, so back to me. I'm going to go with tater tots.
A cousin of hash browns, some would say.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the tater tots here are actually solid.
Yeah.
I just got to say that.
Colgate. Shout out Colgate.
Shout out
Chartwell.
Go-gate.
Chartwell Dining.
Chartwell Dining, yes.
Okay. And then my next one, going to try and do this faster than last week. I'm going to go baked potatoes.
Okay.
And I know that Hayes isn't a big fan of that, but here's the reason why you pick baked potatoes. Because like, if we were talking about how versatile potatoes are, they're kind of just like the most basic form. And like, you can do like loaded potatoes with that. Like you can like get crazy and get all the toppings out on the table and sour cream and butter. And sometimes people put like bacon and cheese and all that stuff in it. And it's just, it's solid.
Yeah. I mean, I can see that. As he said, I'm not a huge baked potato guy. But I've really been very controversial. I'm sure I'm going to lose this because of that. But
yeah, the gnocchi pick was good though.
People might not even know what that is. Actually,
no, people definitely know it.
Faith and gate community.
Okay, so my next pick. This one also might come back to me, but it's au gratin.
What?
I actually saw that when I looked up
it's very
all
good.
Potato foods, but
you're
going to have to explain what it is.
Okay, so it's like you slice a potato up like...
If you have to explain it, it's not a good pick.
No, it's good because it's like cream and there's cheese in there.
Yeah.
It's so good. And my grandma makes them and it's just, it's so
good. It's like a potato that's like sliced? Really?
It's like sliced up and then you put those like slices in like a big like piece of
sheet?
Like glassware. And then you like put like potato layer,
dairy
layer, cheese layer.
Yeah, it's like
and
a
then
potato.
Another,
it's like you a like potato pie.
Can I see a picture of it? I want to see a picture of it.
I've had this before too.
Yeah.
I will say if you don't put enough things on top of it, it does get a little potato-y.
My grandma just makes it with just the perfect here.
Of course.
Here's like a photo.
Okay.
That's
I never had that.
It's
Our
so
listeners
good.
Can't see it, but it
does
look very.
Maybe we'll put it on.
It looks solid.
on our Instagram. Shout out.
Yeah, shout out to the Instagram.
How do you spell that? I'm keeping fools on the hill. I'm keeping
AU space GRATIN. Algratin.
That's so. What area, region of the world is that from?
It's French.
Cool.
It's very good. It's just like when you slice potatoes that thin, it just start, they get so crispy and like
chips.
And it's so nice.
That you don't like.
It's like creamy chips. And cheesy. It's like it kind of can be a stand-in for mashed potatoes.
Mm. No.
Yeah,
Okay.
You guys obviously just haven't had good Algratin.
I just think you think you're better than me because you know these fancy words.
I've had a good version of that dish, but I just think there are better ways.
Okay.
More. I can't believe you took gnocchi. Ways. That's
gross. Yeah. I'm really sad about that too. I'm gonna take something like gnocchi.
If you take the other one that I had.
Okay. Let's see.
I have two here. I have two picks. Oh,
these are really good. Kyle, going for the win. Like you did last
going
week.
Going for
you
birdie.
Had a good solid starting too.
Yeah. So I'm going to go with pierogies, potato pierogies. Mm-hmm. I'm actually very Polish. My whole mom's side of the family is Polish. And so for Christmas Eve, there's also meat pierogies, but... Mm-hmm. But potato pierogies.
Wait, but isn't the dumpling not potato, or is it? Is it just
the
stuffing?
I never knew they made these as potatoes.
Like gnocchi.
Well, gnocchi is the whole thing is potato.
There's no
it's just gnocchi's potato. Not stuffed.
Oh.
Wait, is the outer shell?
No, it's potato. It's, the outer shell's like dumpling, like
but
potato on the inside.
Yeah.
What? Why would you eat that?
I don't
feel like
know.
It's so good. No, but there's potato. It's kind of like you just mix potato with cheese, mushrooms. It's really good. And so I'd say that's one. We get some nice pierogies in this like little place in Chicago for our like big Polish events. And then I'm gonna take potato salad because
interesting.
Not a big fan.
Hayes, you're not a big fan of anything. Except
just like obscure French stuff. Okay,
you pulled up the dictionary and found like potato in the random words.
You're just riding
what
high off your week
your
one win, dude.
What does
I don't
that
know.
Even mean?
You just looked at.
I don't think I'm gonna win this one, but I know that this is the best picks I could have made. So.
Okay. Yeah. No chance.
If that helps you sleep better.
Yeah.
Potato
salad. It's okay. It's
good. Potato fun. Salad is incredible. Okay, like at a barbecue event, potato salad, it's everywhere, okay? And it's good. It's a good thing.
Here's
because
what,
it's not, like, for kids, you don't want, like, sometimes they don't want the super, they don't want just, like, veggies, you know? So you can be like, have some potato salad. Salad's in the name. It endorses the delicacy of itself, and it's just a fantastic
what,
food item.
What I'm going to say is that I always look at potato salad as that thing that you eat when there's like nothing, like when you're looking down the barbecue line and it's like, okay, what do we got? We got pulled pork. We're out of mac and cheese, or you don't have anything. So you just got to have a little bit of potato salad to get some carbs.
That
like,
is so accurate.
Yeah. It's like, I'll take it, I like guess. It. Cause it's okay.
Yeah. I agree with Cal here. Mm.
Okay. But sometimes that's what you got to go with on your last pick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to say my last pick is Hasselback potatoes.
What?
Okay. How have you guys not heard
whatever,
of Hasselback?
Whatever, just explain it.
It's like a potato that's like kind of baked, but it's like chopped on the
what's
top of it.
What's up with you and cutting potatoes?
So
what
your problem, seriously, Hayes, your problem is that if we didn't tell the listeners, but the way we're going to decide the winners, we're going to put it on the Instagram for people to vote. And the problem is half the people aren't going to know what this is and no one's going to want to look it up. So like,
yeah,
I know. I saw you look that up yesterday. Like that's just a baked
just
potato with little slices.
So, it's so good.
You don't have to convince us, dude.
It's so delicious. And it's like, it's nice and crispy. It's got some butter in there. It's not just a baked potato. Okay.
Not just your
it's got like, it crisps up the sides of it, which makes it really good. Mm.
Okay.
I think I agree. I think that I probably kind of blundered these picks, but I like my options. So.
Okay.
Okay.
Personally, I feel like if you were voting on it,
if I was voting on it, I would vote for myself because I like
isn't
these.
Isn't that what, it's just friendly competition, you know?
That's right.
That you're not going to win.
Right. I think Noki might draw some, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll draw me.
My last pick, I think I've got a really good list. I just got to bring it home. I'm going to go with home fries. Okay.
Care to explain?
Yeah.
They sound a lot like fries.
I was deciding between
home fries, but
I was deciding between home fries and roasted potatoes.
I would go with roasted.
And I think Mr. French. Mr. I don't even know what you picked. I can't even remember what you picked. It's just they're good. They're kind of like the poor man's hash browns. I feel like if you can't get hash browns with your breakfast food, home fries are a good substitute. Sometimes they're seasoned really well. I had them at Broad Street Diner here, and they were seasoned really well, and they're tasty. So, yeah. Okay.
That's great.
Good Mount Rushmore, guys. All right. Yeah, good job.
We'll put this up on the Instagram, and people can vote.
At WRCU, Fools on
the Hill. I think it might be Fools on the Hill, WRCU.
Or is it it's WRCU, it's, Fools on the Hill, yeah. Actually. You're confusing everybody, Hayes.
Okay, well.
Just like you confused us with your picks.
Okay, the picks were good picks. They were good picks.
We'll see.
No, it's for the voters to decide. Yeah, for the voters
to decide. Well, for people who maybe are like, know what they're talking about when they're talking about potatoes, then maybe that will be a good pick.
But. Sure. Yeah. All right, well, we have a quick break, and then we're going to be listening to Immigrant Song by Led Zeppelin.
What is dedication?
My biggest fear in the middle of my addiction was that my kids wouldn't have a father. I overdosed on heroin, and I lived. And I started thinking, you know what? This isn't my story. My desire to change had finally outweighed my desire to stay the same. I felt powerless for so much of my life. It's important to me that my kids are empowered and truly believe that if they can think it, they can do it. I definitely had to become a better man to be a better father. For the first time, I finally feel like I'm exactly where I should be, where I want to be.
That's dedication. Visit fatherhood.gov to hear more. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Drive our ships to me.
All right, guys, that was our show for today. Thank you for listening to The Fools on the Hill. How did you guys think it went?
Yeah, it's great. Well. I'm still kind of reeling from the Mount Rushmore.
Yeah, I think I took it, you guys.
I don't know, maybe.
We'll see.
We'll have to see.
It's up for the voters now.
What again, the people have to say.
Again, at WRCU Fools on the Hill on Instagram. Vote, you know, we want this to be interactive. So let us know what you think. Yeah, our final song for today is going to be Wild World by Cat Stevens, who was also known as Yusef when he converted to Islam for a short bit. Fun fact about him. Right. But anyway, here's Wild World.
Everything to you. You say you wanna start something new, and it's breaking my heart, you're leaving.